This episode was made in partnership with the Kavli Prize. The Kavli Prize honors scientists for breakthroughs in astrophysics, nanoscience, and neuroscience, transforming our understanding of the very big, the very small, and the very complex. And in 2020, the Kavli Prize in neuroscience was awarded to two scientists, David Julius of the University of California, San Francisco, and Artem Patapoudian of Scripps Research Institute, who studied how we feel pain from heat to pressure. We did not fully understand how that basic bodily function works until recently. They cracked the code of these sensations with the help of lots of hot peppers and skin pinches. Pain can come from quite a few different sources, but their research suggests that pain from various sources can be processed by our bodies in a surprisingly similar way. Hot stoves and habaneros might seem like very different kinds of heat, but they trigger the same internal response. You see, some of your body's pain sensors are sensitive to a chemical found in hot peppers called capsaicin. This chemical makes it easier for molecules with a positive charge, or cations, to pass through the outer layer of a pain receptor cell. When cations like sodium and calcium pass into a cell, its internal charge builds up enough current to activate the cell to do its job. In this case, the cell's job is to alert the rest of the body to potentially dangerous stimuli like heat. But until now, we didn't know how capsaicin triggers this response in pain cells. So David Julius's team of scientists went on a search to find the gene that makes capsaicin responsive cells. Once they found that gene, they confirmed that it was only found in sensory neurons that respond to heat. So next, they tested how these cells respond to different kinds of heat. In one experiment, they put some tissue into a petri dish and added a 65 degrees Celsius solution for it to float around in. And in another experiment, they added capsaicin to the solution that the tissue was floating in. Both kinds of heat produced the same physiological response and activated cells in their dish. And they found that the mechanism was calcium dependent. Within seconds of applying heat, they measured more calcium in the pain cells. So both kinds of heat triggered similar increases in current flowing into the pain cells, which were not observed in control cells. From these experiments, they discover that capsaicin opens a channel that lets calcium flow in and activate pain cells. And while several different kinds of heat can trigger this mechanism in similar ways, heat is not the only thing that triggers it. Artem Patapoudian's research team figured out that these cation channels can also be activated by pressure. Because pain doesn't just come from touching a hot stove, it can also come from, like, closing a drawer on your fingers. In an experiment where the researchers applied pressure to individual cells, they found that greater pressure leads to more current flowing into the cell, so it works in a similar way to heat sensation. And they named the gene that makes pressure-sensitive ion channels piezo, after the Greek word piezi, which means pressure. And then they found similar piezo genes all over the plant and animal kingdoms. Vertebrates like us have two piezo genes. The channel that piezo 1 encodes for conducts cations with a preference for calcium, similar to what was described by Julius's group, and it's found around the membrane where this kind of channel would be useful. Piezo 2 is similar to piezo 1, but it works faster. The Patapoudian lab concluded that without functioning piezo 2 channels, you wouldn't be able to differentiate between painful and harmless touch. Everything would just feel like a nice touch. They were able to do this in mice with piezo 2 channels that they could basically turn on and off, and when they turned the piezo 2 channels back on, they would recover their ability to sense painful stimuli. Now, you might be thinking that you'd like to permanently close all your piezo channels because pain isn't great, but individuals with SIPA, or congenital insensitivity to pain and anhidrosis, don't respond to noxious stimuli. They often inadvertently harm themselves, and many die before the age of 25. So pain is protective and incredibly important to us, but we need a balance. On the other end of the spectrum, there are people who are oversensitive to touch and experience allodynia. If you have allodynia, you might feel chronic pain triggered by a harmless touch, from like a paintbrush. And Patapoudian's team believe that piezo 2 is an excellent candidate to treat allodynia. These studies are piecing together the pain puzzle so more people can live in that balanced sweet spot. And the more we understand the science behind the everyday sensations of heat and cold and pressure, the better we can understand how to treat conditions related to them. Thanks for watching this episode of SciShow, and thank you again to the Kavli Prize for supporting this episode and for supporting science. The Kavli Prize in neuroscience is awarded for outstanding achievement achievement in advancing our knowledge and understanding of the brain and nervous system. They also award a Nanoscience and Astrophysics Prize, honoring researchers for transforming our understanding of the science of the atomic, molecular, and cellular structures, and advancing our knowledge of the origin, evolution, and properties of the universe. If you want to learn more about 2020's neuroscience laureates David Julius and Artem Patapoudian, you can visit their page on the Kavli Prize website by clicking on the link in the description.